Hello everyone. This video is the continuation of the previous video in which we looked at the anti-Ackerman geometry construction. In this video, we are going to look at Ackerman geometry construction, and at the end of the video, I will also show you how to perform and check the inner angle and outer angle and any hindrance with the chassis or car body. So let us quickly dive into the video. This is just a normal representation of the suspension layout. And you can see, like, most commonly the arrangement of the steering linkage and mechanism in the Ackerman geometry is behind the front axle. So this, if you join the line from wheel center, and behind that you will see the arrangement for Ackerman geometry, and these are the number of parts and the name and their name written over here. So let us open Solidworks. So I have here with me the front axle and rear axle layout, and this is the wheelbase representation. So I will take a new sketch. We'll make it in top plane. Okay. So first of all, this is the wheel center. So from here, I will just make a steering arm. Then some clearance for the mounting. Then a line at angle, some clearance. And again some clearance, then clearance for rack, then the rack body, then some clearance for right hand side for the rack, then again some, let us make it from this side. So this is the right hand side steering arm, some clearance. Then some clearance for tie rod. Okay, so this is tie rod. So now you see all the small lines. Okay, so these are just clearance. Okay, which I have made for the reference. Okay, so I will make it construction. Okay, and so these three lines should be collinear. We can make it join here. So this length we can give around 100. And this all small lines will be 30 mm clearance. Okay, so you can select the first one, which you have given the dimension, and select all the small dotted lines and make it equal. Okay, so rack position from the front axle, I'm giving 200, and the rack length, let us give around 250. And so we will be moving this whole mechanism. So just for now, I am fixing the position of this at center, and I will delete this immediately midpoint. Okay. Because I want the rack to move. Okay. So this and this should be equal. Okay. And rack length we have defined. This is very big tie rod, so 400. Let's keep 350. Same here. Okay. So now you see the steering arm is going very much inside. Okay. So it is because the tie rod is very much long and steering rack is very much short. Say if I make it 350, the angle will reduce. Okay, but yeah, if I do symmetry, then it will be symmetry. Yes. So for the time, we don't want symmetry, like the midpoint. Okay. Now we will make the spindle. So make like this and give any angle. Let's say I want to maintain an angle of 105 degrees between the spindle and the steering arm. Okay. So first what you do. Okay. So we need to measure the angle, how much it is between this and this. So it is 176, almost 4 degrees. So I can make it 109. And or let's just make it collinear with this and delete that collinearity. So now what has happened? This line is exactly same with respect to this. Okay. Give some length to spindle, let us say 100. Okay. And keep it horizontal. And 109 is going to be the default angle when your tires are straight. Okay. So we can delete this horizontal because we want this to move. So if you see now, yes, if you see your steering is performing the way you want. And this is a way to verify also. Okay. So now I will make it here as well. Length will be 100. And the angle should be same, what you have kept in the left hand side. So 109 we need to do and check. Yeah, that is also moving. And so you can have a angle, a common angle to move it. So let us say I'm making a common angle for both left hand side and right hand side with respect to center axis. So if you will give 90, it will be very straight. It will be default position. Your wheels will be having no steering angle. They will be aligned perfectly in a straight line direction. Okay. So now you can control, like you can give 120 degree and like this, the steering angle will change. You can see. So this geometry is completed here and you can add the tires also. So for adding tires, we need to make this, need to make the use of this feature in sketch. So this is a top view, so that's why the tire looks like a rectangle. You need to make it parallel and get some dimension. So width, no, this is not the width. So width you can give around 120. And overall tire diameter, let it be 500. Okay. So you see when you change the angle, the tire will also move like that. Okay. So we'll make it 135. Yeah, you see now we'll make it on the other side. This is parallel 120. And 500. So currently the angle, effective angle, is 45 degree. Okay. So the angle of the this left hand side wheel is around 45, and that of right hand side is, let us check now. Okay, so it is, if you minus it with the 120, so this will come out to be some 26 degree. Okay, so this is the indication also, like how to identify Ackerman steering geometry. When you turn left or right, the inner wheel will always have greater steering angle than the outer steering wheel. So this is what happening in this case. Okay, so we'll keep it 90, so this will be straight. Okay, so let's have one more look. So this is going to be spindle, steering arm, tie rod. Now here what I have done is, so there you will mount using nut and bolts. So for that we have given clearance, because sometimes we need to shorten the center to center length, and we need to do adjustments like toe in and toe out. Okay, so yeah, that is how you can check, and that is how you can make a simple Ackerman steering geometry layout in Solidworks. I hope you like the video. Please also subscribe to my channel, and I hope to make more videos like this. Okay, so thank you so much. Thanks so much for watching.